are so many plants in one place, of course we get problems with insects. We want to scout the insects, which insects is in the greenhouse. That's why we use this yellow plate with glue on it. And the yellow color attracts the insect and it sticks. So we can look on the yellow plate and count the insects and which insect is in the greenhouse. Aphids and thrips are one of the main problems. Can bring over viruses and other bacterial diseases. So that's why we don't want thrips. It can destroy your complete harvest.
These tomato plants are now 7 weeks old. It was not treated with mycorrhizal fungi and bacteria, but it received the usual fertilization treatment. As you can see, the plant grows well, and we think it's an okay plant. But if we compare it to treatments with mycorrhizal fungi and bacteria, we will see tremendous difference. These tomato plants have also been seeded at March 12. These tomato plants have not received any fertilizers, but they have received mycorrhizal fungi and bacteria. And these plants received at least 50%, 60% less water than usual. So the mycorrhizae and the bacteria help the plant not only to take up nutrients, but they help also the plant to take up water. These plants look healthy, vital, and they already form buds. This means that they are going to flower soon and to set the first fruits. And that is rather rapid after 7 weeks already.
Now we are doing this big trial with the water boxes. Of course, it's always very interesting to make a competition with a normal system and the water box system. That's why we planted here the plants directly into the soil and giving them water like a normal grower should do. And then we are looking what will be best.
These tomato plants have received a unique mix of high quality mycorrhizal fungi. In fact, the producer has a quality label on his mycorrhizal fungi. And you can see that if you use a high quality mycorrhizal fungus, it's more effective than if we use a mycorrhizal fungi that has not a quality control label and is of more low quality. These plants have also received mycorrhizal fungi, but this is not a unique mix with mycorrhizal fungi that are of high quality and have a quality control label. The plants are still bigger than the plants treated with fertilizers, in fact are twice as big, but they do not form buds yet. And we see that they are a little bit less vigorous. Maybe they develop okay over time, but still they're behind the plants that have received unique high-quality mycorrhizal fungi.
The last 2 months, what happened in the greenhouse with the tile of the water boxes?
Well, here we see plants grown in special boxes. These boxes are called rhizotrons.